Have you ever tried to remove a liquid from another liquid? It's not really that easy. There's a reason that they say oil and water don't mix, and it's not just because they literally don't mix. Hey everyone, thank you for watching DNews today. I'm Trace. Oil is a mainstay for modern post-industrial revolution society. We run our engines and heat and power our homes with it. And even with all the precautions and cost involved, sometimes we accidentally spill it everywhere. Most recently in Refugio State Beach on the central coast of California on May 19th, but also in Yellowstone National Park, in Montana, in the Black Sea, Israel, Louisiana, Indiana, Curacao, and in North Dakota thrice. And that's just in the last year and a half. Cleaning up the spill is heavily studied. But what happens later? What happens 5, 10, 50 years after an oil spill? Is everything just hunky-dory? Not at all. On March 24, 1989, the Exxon Valdez oil tanker ran aground, spilling more than 11 million gallons of crude oil into waters off the coast of Alaska. At the time, it was the largest oil spill in U.S. history. More than 1,000 miles of shoreline were covered in the toxic hydrocarbon chemical, and more than 2,000 sea otters, 300 harbor seals, and 250,000 seabirds died following the spill. The Exxon Valdez was a huge story when I was a kid, and by volume, it was only eclipsed by the April 2010 Deepwater Horizon spill by BP. These two spills are affecting flora and fauna in massive numbers, but now, years later, what's happening? Even after cleanup is considered done, oil is still in the environment. For example, tarballs wash up onshore months or years later. Tarballs are crusty, weathered balls filled with a soft, gooey oil, like a toasted marshmallow of death. When I think of an oil spill, I picture water with a thin layer of oil on top, spreading for miles, which is the first stage of the spill. Eventually, the sun, wind, waves, ocean bacteria, and other forces act on that oil, creating tarballs. The sun helps evaporate the lighter components, leaving behind the heavy chemical compounds. Sand and tiny particles in the ocean water collect into the oil, and the sun, waves, and wind form the oil into an emulsion. The National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, or NOAA, says it looks like chocolate pudding and is even stickier than the original spilled oil. If it comes in contact with the beach or a rock, it can crack open again, causing new tiny oil spills. Some cleanups are so severe, the topmost layer of sand is completely removed on a beach and new uncontaminated sand is brought in. Scientific American wrote in 2003 that bacterial growth is inhibited on beaches, and in Alaska, toxicity remained for a decade or more. Mammals and ducks will eat prey that are contaminated with oil. Mussel beds are still recovering in Alaska. An estimated time for that? 30 years. According to the National Wildlife Foundation, turtles and dolphins are still being affected by oil in the Gulf, with turtles stranding themselves at 5 times the normal rate, and a new study in PLOS ONE finding adrenal and lung lesions in Gulf dolphins because of the inhalation of oil fumes when they come up for air. Under the water, life is also hit hard whenever oil spills. But humans are quick to forget and move on because, you know, we don't live down there. Coral in the Gulf were covered in oil, and dead and dying coral were found 7 miles from the BP spill site. A study published in Science after the Exxon Valdez spill found even a few molecules of oil out of every billion, known as parts per billion, was enough to harm some animals, like salmon, whose mortality rates increased for years after the spill because sensitive fish eggs were contacted by tiny amounts of toxic crude oil. Oil is toxic. Inhalation or ingestion of and contact with hydrocarbons can be really bad for humans and animals. But the decades of cleanup and response can affect the ecosystem in so many ways. Even the propellers of boats can disturb and kill wildlife. Today, 26 years later, oil is still found on the beaches of Alaska, and although some species have returned to pre-spill levels, some species of fish, whale, and bird are not recovering at all. More recently, NOAA created a model of how sea currents likely carried the BP Deepwater Horizon oil along the Gulf Coast past Florida into the Caribbean and the Atlantic. Though years go by and the media move on, spills like these go on to affect waterways for generations to come. So when spills like these do happen, who pays for all the cleanup? Luckily, Test Tube's crack research team explored that exact thing right here.
Well, usually the company overseeing the oil when it's spilled is the most at fault. But there are cases where a single person is charged as well. The captain of a ship which spills oil, for instance, may be investigated for negligence.
Thank you for watching DNews. Please subscribe so that you get all of our videos twice a day, every day. And come follow us on Twitter. You can find the whole team at DNews, or you can find me at Trace Dominguez.